Academy Award winner and comedian Monique has come to the Valley for her own residency. Starts at the SLS Las Vegas tonight.
Which is all great, and I'm really happy for Monique, and I'm happy that she's here. Monique, great to have you.
Hi. Thank you so much, Sean. Get ready to be personal,
but I'm going to let you go ahead. Right at the top.
Turn it personal.
The only thing we have, Monique,
come on,
is the fact that we're great at cornhole.
Yes.
But you...
Come on.
She's just showing us up.
We're a cornhole champion in elementary
school. Okay, because this is what happened, right, JJ? And I don't have any problem sharing. But as I was sitting here and I heard all of the accolades you guys were giving yourselves, we are the cornhole champs.
Yes.
No one can beat us. No one. You've been here for 9 years. We've been here for how long? 3 years, which means you really don't have all of that experience, okay? 9 and 3. I've been cornholing. Since the third grade.
Ooh.
Talk on it. Ooh. Talk on it. I hold the championship from Woodmore Elementary School for the best cornhole chucker they have.
Give us an idea of third grade Monique. Where was your elementary school? Where did you grow up?
In Baltimore, Maryland. My elementary school was in Baltimore, Maryland, Woodmore Elementary. And you know it's so funny because someone said to me, when did Monique become Monique?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I said, I think the day I came here, which was December 11th, 1967. But she said, when did Monique get that fight? When did Monique get, I said, I think it started in the third grade. Yes, it started in the third grade. I had a teacher, Mr. McKinney.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now my sister's here to back this story. Mr. McKinney, remember this? Remember third grade, right? And Mr. McKinney separated the classroom. Right? And he separated all the white kids and all the black kids.
Oh,
that's what he did, Sean.
For real?
What? This is for real, Sugar. He separated the class, Sean, and he told the white kids, y'all can color. And he told us, I'm gonna teach y'all how to talk correctly.
Oh my God.
This is what I did, Sean.
Oh no.
Sean, look what I did.
Oh my.
Look what I did, Sean.
Wow.
Sean, look what I did.
Yes, Monique.
I'm in the third grade. Call on me, you the teacher, be Mr. McKinney.
Yes, Monique.
Can I go to the office?
Would you have to go to the bathroom?
I have to call my father.
Why is this?
Because they talk just like we talk, and I want to color like they color.
Oh my, wow. Mm.
Now, what do you think Mr. McKinney did?
I have no idea. We're unearthing a lot of
stuff
here.
Mr. McKinney brought that class back together and looked at me like a little girl, but I looked at him like, I know something don't make sense about that.
Of course.
So you need to bring us back together.
Where is he today?
Mr. McKinney today, I don't know, but you know what? I love him because he was smart enough. To bring it back together.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
You see, he was smart enough to see through it and bring it back together, and he didn't want to talk to my father either.
Oh my gosh.
And you're bringing everything together at the SLS segue.
Yes.
Everything together at the SLS.
Wyatt.
Black, white, Hispanic, Asian, everyone invited to your show.
That's what laughter is.
Yep.
Laughter is colorless. Mm-hmm. Laughter and love, it doesn't have a gender, it doesn't have a color, it doesn't have a religion, it just feels good. Mm-hmm. And that's what this show is for me. It's a feel good. I don't care what color you are, I don't care what gender you are. If you wanna come and laugh, and I'm talking about that kind of laugh, JJ, because when we're older girls, laughing can get different. Okay? When you're older, JJ, we must talk about it.
A trickle laugh.
Let's talk about it now, Sean. When you're an older girl, laughing can get a little different, right?
It's a little surprise.
It's a little surprise with it, but that's what this show is. It's a little surprise, a whole lot of love, and a big bundle of laughter.
That's fantastic.
Mm. Yeah.
I love it. How did you get into comedy in the first place? The first experience, on stage, mic, people looking at you for humor. What was that moment?
Okay, that was the moment that I said, I want to do this forever.
Really?
Because as a child, now this may sound vain, but it's honest. Mm-hmm. I've always loved attention. Please look at me. Please look at me, baby. As a child, I would shake. My grandmother would take me to. My grandmother would take me to the secondhand store, Miss Bell's, right?
Yeah.
And Miss Bell was my grandmother's only friend. This was so beautiful. Okay, so go back to the 70s, right? Miss Bell was this really big white woman who wore red lipstick. And my grandmother was this really short, very dark woman, but they were each other's friends. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But they could only be friends in that store. So it was so beautiful, right?
Mm.
But they would cheer me on. So they would dress me up in all the secondhand things. I would itch sometimes, you know, but it's okay. You know, and I would come out and I would just shake. She would go, shake it, Nikki. Shake it, Nikki. Shake it. So I love the attention.
Yeah.
So the first night I got up to do stand up, I had actually dared my brother because he tried it. He was horrible, baby. Listen.
No.
In his mind, he was Richard Pryor, Eddie Murphy, all rolled up in one. But in the audience mind, they booed his behind off of that stage.
Oh, no.
I teased him. He dared me. The next weekend, I went up on that stage, and everyone was looking at me, Sean.
Oh, boy, that's a dream.
All eyes were on me, and I just began to have a great time. And at the end of that, those people stood up, and they were like, and I was like, oh, I'm in the secondhand store.
Shake it.
So from that moment to this, I've always loved it, and I still get the same feeling I get I got that night.
Yeah.
When I walked up on that stage.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And now you're here in Vegas and we get to see at the SLS?
Yes.
You know, I'm gonna tell you something. To be the first black woman in the history of Las Vegas to have a residency as a comedian.
Wait a second, is that the truth?
Well, no, Sean, I'm just lying right now.
Yeah, is that true?
It didn't even dawn on me. That's incredible.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Mm. Thank you very much.
Long time coming.
But it says a lot for the SLS Hotel, because it is a long time coming. So to hold that position is an honor.
Yeah.
I'm grateful because there are so many before me that opened it up so that I could, that never got a chance to get the residency, but they kicked the door in so that I could walk up on that stage. That's Moms Mabel, that's Thea Vidal, that's Marsha Warfield, that's so many before me. So to be able to say the first, I want to thank all the ones that came before me so that I could say I'm the first
That's phenomenal.
Black female comedian.
Well, we're very happy to have you in our city.
Thank you, sweetness. We're proud
that you're going to be headlining over the SLS. People get to see you starting tonight. Thank you so much, Monique.
Thank you, my loves. And y'all should win that daytime Emmy. Let me just put it out there.
There we go. You. You heard it.
Y'all have my vote.
Put it on the tape.
Put it on it. Now, Sean, don't make me get aggressive. Don't you become Mr. McKinney. Don't do it now. Bring us back together.
She is Monique. She does Las Vegas inside the Sayers Club at the SLS Las Vegas. It all begins tonight, and it's not going to stop. Not going to stop till she's done.
Come on,
right?
Baby.
She'll be there regularly Thursday through Saturday through March 30th. Could go on longer. You can get tickets by visiting the website or calling the number right there on your screen.
Love Monique.